One last thing I wanted to kind of do to clean up the display of our attributes is talk about categories. We've kind of mentioned them here and there throughout the course so far, but we haven't really put them to use. As your attribute list starts to get longer and longer for specific elements, it can be very useful to start assigning categories to attributes so that they're grouped in a way that makes sense to you. So for instance, here we have 3, 6, 8 attributes, and by the time we get into our derived templates, say for the blower, we add another 3, that's 11 attributes. So it's going to be kind of a long list. So I'm going to go in here and start assigning some categories to these. So for all this stuff we pulled out of the table, and it's kind of static data, I'm going to give it a category of nameplate data. And it's going to say, oh, I don't have that category available. Would you like to create it? I'll say yes. And now you see if I go to the rest of these, I can click on this little category button. And I have that category available to me. Let's see if I can assign multiple ones at once. It looks like I can. I forgot serial number. And then for things like power and status, let's just call those real-time data. Again, I'll create that category. And now you see there's these checkboxes here. I can actually add multiple categories if I want. So any attribute can fall into multiple categories. It doesn't have to just have one category. So that can be pretty useful too if you want to organize attributes under multiple categories. So again, I just want to call status real-time data. And then these categories are universal to this database now, so I can go to any of these other templates and start applying the same categories. So now I have these all categorized, and we'll see when we start building our elements out how we can group the various categories. I'll go ahead and check all that work in. And actually, if you want to see a preview of this, there's this group by, and it says I can either group by category or template. Here I want to group by category. And you'll see that now all my attributes, all my nameplate data is grouped here, and all my real-time data is grouped here. And the nice thing about categorizing data is we can collapse these categories. So if we only want to see data from a specific category, we can expand that one. So it's a nice little organizational tool when you're looking at long lists of attributes in PySystem Explorer. It can also be used with something like PyOADB to quickly find specific types of data. And if you take our second course in AF, you'll see how categories come into play when we set up roll-up expressions to calculate sums over multiple elements. So now that we have all of the templates we need for the equipment, let's go ahead and start building out our hierarchy and adding our equipments to the different zones.